Yeah, first of all the credit in the world to Western Illinois. I thought, Coach Wright had their squad ready to go. They had a tremendous game plan. They're physical. They were aggressive. And they deserved to win the game, quite frankly. So proud of our guys that we continued to fight, even in adversity. But they did a great job establishing themselves early in the game. And so credit to them. And we weren't able to make enough plays late.
Mike, you guys were in this exact same situation really last year. Why were you not able this time to make that run in the second half and find a way to get back in and win it?
I wouldn't say it was just the end of the game things. It was what we did at the start of the game, our slow start. We had so many turnovers, and I think all of that in the end led to us not making the right plays at the very end. I mean, yeah, we hit some heroic shots, we got some old boards, but everything accumulates to the whole game and how our turnovers and stops early, that kind of killed us, I would say, looking through it down the stretch.
Tevin, did you feel like you guys overlooked them as an 8 seed?
I wouldn't say that. I mean, they just came out really physical and aggressive. I mean, they had all the momentum going towards their way, and then they stuck with it. They stuck with their principles, the foundation they had to hold us. I mean, they just stuck to it.
Any other questions for the student athletes? Oh, right back up front if no one else other than Matt.
You guys tried to make a bunch of runs in the second half and they just continued to make tough shots. How demoralizing is that when you guys are trying to make runs and they just keep hitting tough shots?
It's tough. I mean, obviously you want to try to make a miss, but when certain guys' shots are falling, then you just got to live with it. You got to find a way to make people miss. We didn't do that at the end.
Tevin, was there a point in the second half where it started to feel like maybe you guys were pressing, that you weren't playing with the confidence that you would find a way to make that run?
I just think we was just a little off. I mean, they came out really aggressive, so it kind of threw us off. And, you know, just going into the second half, I felt like we had the energy going into it. I mean, they just made a couple runs, made some shots, and capitalized off our turnovers.
Mike, how deflating is this? I mean, you've won it all 3 years, and now obviously you wanted your senior year to be the best one, and this happened.
To be blunt, it sucks. It really sucks. But for us, you know, we're gonna get a bid into the NIT, so we still get to play games in the postseason. We still have more games to come up. For us, it's another loss. It's any loss we had at the start of the season. It's the exact same thing now. So for us, we turn around tomorrow, wake up in the morning, get back to work. We know we have games coming up. We know the sun's going to come back up. So, I mean, it's really no time to really get down on ourselves. Of course, we're going to sulk on it a little bit tonight. Guys are going to be in their feelings, but who isn't in their feelings after a loss? So for us, you know, we just got to keep moving forward, realize that we still have games left with this core group of guys, and just keep getting closer together as a team.
Mike, you were stuck on 4 points for a while. What were they doing to keep the ball away from you, to keep you from generating points? I mean, you finished with 16, but as you said, the accumulation of the game, first 30 minutes of it, you weren't nearly as involved as you usually are. What were they doing?
I wouldn't necessarily say it was anything they were doing. I mean, we knew that they were going to put Gilbeck on me, so our game plan was to space them and our guys to get downhill. So if 4 points is what I started with, then 4 points is what I ended with, and that's what we needed to do to win the game, then that's what I would have done. We made sure that, you know, Gilbeck stayed out of the paint so our guys could get downhill and drive.
Matt?
TJ, what do you think was the biggest factor that cost you this game?
I think the physicality. I think they did a good job preparing. Similar to last year, we knew it was going to be a heck of a game. We knew it was going to be even more physical. Coach Wright did a tremendous job getting those guys ready to go, and I think that physicality took us out of our rhythm, right? We like to play free and open in space. It just felt like the game was choppy for that reason. We never really got our rhythm. I felt like the first half, I mean, everybody's talking about the second half, but the first half's the one we didn't play very well. Right. If we'd have played the second half over again, we'd have been in great shape. We had great rhythm and pace, and we got to the basket, and we got the shots we needed. But, again, credit to them. They did a heck of a job. Great game plan, great execution, and the physicality was really the difference.
Well, it did take till there was about 5 minutes left to really make that run and get into it. Did you think at all that your team, you know, has been here so many times and had so much success here, and it's kind of the home court advantage? Do you think they got a little bit complacent? It didn't look like there was a sense of urgency until very late in the game.
Yeah, I don't think that was the issue at all. And I think, you know, we've got three seniors and four guys who have been here, so it's not like we've got 10. We've got a lot of guys that are freshmen. That was the first time they've ever been on that court. So I know that we've got three guys as seniors and one guy's a sophomore who've played. But other than that, there's not a lot of experience out there. I don't think for a second there's any complacency. I don't think for a second that our guys took the game lightly or thought we could come back at any time. I thought we had a great week of practice. I thought they were extremely focused. And I think all the credit goes to Western Illinois for how they executed their game plan, and they were physical.
I'll ask the same question about Dom. What did you see that they were doing or you guys weren't doing enough to get Dom freed up so you can get the rest of your game freed up?
Yeah, it was, you know, our offensive flow wasn't really good. I think, again, it was a more physical game. So we weren't able to go in space as much as we usually do. I think everybody would realize if, you know, with Gilbeck, he's a big physical guy. He's the nation's leader in shot blocks. So, you know, part of their game plan and where they're helping off on other guys, too, is part of it. It's not just give Mike the ball and let him make magic happen. There's other guys in gaps. They're making choices to make it not easy on Mike, which is really smart of them. And they did a good job executing it throughout the course of the game. So we didn't have the normal pace and flow that we're used to playing with.
How much of it was just shots not going down? At one point, you guys were 2 of 14 beyond the arc.
Yeah, I mean, for our group, that's very uncommon. I mean, I think we're second in the nation in three-point percentage. We make them at 42% and make over 10 a game. So to go 5 for 20 and to start out the way we did, that's very uncharacteristic of our group. I know that there's a lot of other things I'd like to change and wish we did differently, but part of this game is making shots, and we didn't make them at the rate we normally do.
Missed free throws, too.
Yeah, there was certainly those. But look, I couldn't be happier for the group of guys we have. We're not here to make excuses or find out reasons why. Just like when we win, there's a reason why. Western was the better team. They played harder and more aggressive. They deserved to win the game. So we can pick out all the little things, a 50-50 ball, what didn't happen here, what didn't happen there. We need to focus our attention. Western had a great game, played a great game, had a great game plan. They were the better team tonight.
How bad do you just feel about this, being that it's Mike's senior year, those two other guys' senior year, and obviously all these fans come out here expecting to see three basketball games?
Yeah, I mean, I know our, you know, with our student-athletes, the sense of pride they play with night in and night out. We have so much respect for our fans, people that support us. We're so grateful for the crowd and the support we have tonight. We talked about it as a group. I mean, they deserve better. We expect more as a program. I don't think anybody's happy about the result. Our guys, I can tell you for sure that Mike Dom and Tevin King and Skylar Flatten. Those guys are jackrabbits through and through and always will be. And the sense of gratitude and appreciation they have for our fans is off the charts. So certainly we're not happy with the outcome, but I can tell you that the passion and pride our guys have for the program and the appreciation for their fans couldn't be any better.
Time for one final question.
Coach, I know this is really hard to answer right now, but you're still in the NIT. How are you going to kind of pick these guys up after this and get them to go out and hopefully make a run in that tournament?
Yeah, that's what we talked about in the locker room. I mean, our guys are winners. They're not going to – yeah, this hurts tonight. It hurts for all of us. We're not going to dwell on it. We're going to use it to fuel the fire, to practice harder this week, to get more out of each day, to be the best that we can be going in the NIT. It's not the position that we wanted to be in, but I know that the group of guys, I know the young men that we recruit, the character that they have, the work ethic they have, and the togetherness that we're going to use this to our benefit and be better for it. So it's a hard life lesson to learn, but I can assure you that we'll be a team that when we get to the NIT, we're not going to be a team that a lot of people want to see.
Thanks very much, Coach.
Appreciate it. Thanks, guys.